When you're ready.
Don't fire away. Nah, man, it was a lot of fun tonight. Just the way the schedule unfolded, I decided to do a night scrimmage. Great to be under the lights inside of Neyland. Guys had a ton of energy and a lot of really good work. And defensively, I thought they started extremely fast. Violent, disruptive, got off the field on third downs, did a great job. Offensively settled in on the second half of the scrimmage. So a lot of good work here for just being over the midpoint of spring ball, and obviously got a huge week next week before we get a chance to see Ball Nation out here on spring game. So open it up.
What's your locking so far on defense? Is that mostly coming from those veterans on the front?
Some of it, absolutely. Our defensive line has brought great energy and consistency every single day that we've been on the practice field. Veteran group, especially on the interior, that has kind of led the way. Our edge group continues to get better. And the young guys and new guys have really grown inside of it really quickly. And they're playing with great pad level. They're using their hands better than they ever have. And I'm not just talking in pass rushing, in the run game too. So really like what that group's done.
Was it strategic to build up that D-line over this point of time? Is this how you thought it would be, having this much depth up there?
Yeah, you want to be really good as a football team. It starts with your defensive line. And, just how we got here, everything that the circumstances that were here when we first got here. It's taken a little time to build that group up, but certainly – just the athleticism across the entire group, and so really like what Coach Banks, Coach Garner, and Coach Eckler have done with that group, and we still got a lot of room to grow before we're where we need to be when we open up.
Coach, when you went out of when we met with him, he told the young guys there would be some dark days. How do you see? But they would be better on the other side. Yeah. How do you see that young group growing, given what you just talked about, depth that they're going through?
Yeah, they're a lot better today than they were when we started spring ball. It won't just be on the back end of it. It's a group that I like their athleticism. They got to continue to mature physically. Those guys, a lot of them are doubling up their reps right now with a lot of our vets, just from the end of the season being banged up and not repping here in spring ball. With everything that we see on the other side of the line of scrimmage, the communication, understanding of what we're doing, fundamentally getting better. They're playing so much harder than they were at the beginning of spring ball, too. So that group's got to continue to grow, but I really do like the group as a whole.
Staying on the offensive line, obviously, with you guys, hope you have Cooper every game next season, but if he goes down, you don't have him like last year. How are some of those young guys at center coming along? Yeah. Bison, William, anybody else that's working?
Bison's continuing to grow. Strong kid, continuing to grow in the communication side of it with his hand on the ball. Satterwhite, Max Anderson's taking some snaps. All those guys, they're getting thrown into they're thrusted into it, and they've handled it really well. And when I say that, they handle coming back from a bad play or a bad series and resetting to the next one too. So a lot of growth left for that group, but they pushed extremely hard, and they did that before we got to spring ball, but they've certainly done it here in the middle of it too.
Certainly feels like you're a little more athletic a receiver this spring. What did you say out of that group tonight?
Yeah, some guys made some plays. Some of the new guys, Brazel made some really nice plays today. Mike Matthews made some plays down the football field. Dante Thornton made some plays, continues to grow. It looked like you were ready to interrupt me there.
How much more confident is he just outside?
Yeah, I think his, last year with where we were at, with the guys that we had, started him in the slot, he got work on the outside. He was so limited in spring ball and training camp, got banged up. He missed a lot of practices and missed opportunities to grow within what we're doing. We moved him outside in the middle part of last year. He was playing his best football, got dinged up. It's a guy that has great trust in the coaching staff, understands just how to operate and function within our offense, and understands coverages in a better way. He's just continuing to grow out there. I really like what he's done.
What was your assessment of Nico and just how the passing game overall looked?
Yeah, just in general, I thought he operated and functioned extremely well tonight. made some plays, did that with his arm, made it with his feet too. We didn't start super fast on the offensive side of the football. I had some opportunities, just didn't get points out of it. I just thought his like competitive composure was really big, and it was kind of his demeanor in general. And I was just continuing to grow in the leadership role too, so really pleased with what he's done. That's tonight, and just through the first part of spring ball.
How do you manage the veterans in terms of how much work they get, like a Keenan Peely, and obviously you've got some veterans on the offensive line. How do you manage that, and what's your assessment of your running backs now after another week or so without Cam and behind Dylan, where you're at there?
Yeah. I hope I remember all your questions.
There was only two.
Okay. What was the first one?
The first one is, how do you manage the veterans?
It's on a case-by-case basis. Amount of football that they played, their health, coming back from injury, watching their loads, potentially continuing to grow that through spring ball. Smart with them on the back end of it here as we get to the back half of next week, too. So it's a little bit case-by-case. The running backs tonight, he brought up Sean Bishop. I thought he ran extremely well tonight. Without watching the film, I'd say probably his best football that he's played this spring. He's no guy coming back off of injury that is getting more comfortable as he's gone through the spring. And so really like what he did. Cleef had a good night too.
How different of a jump do you see in the transfers when you go from scrimmage to scrimmage compared to the vets that are on the team? What's that difference look like?
Yeah, you hope to see a great amount of growth from scrimmage to scrimmage, and that's with your new guys inside of your system that can be transfers and your high school kids came in mid-year too. And I thought with everything that was going on tonight for them on the field, they handled it pretty well. Now get a chance to go back and watch the film and actually see everything that happened.
I'm sure you want nice weather away from Saturday, but tonight you kind of had like an early November type night.
Yeah.
How much does that kind of just give you the simulation of what it could be like in the fall? How much does it help those young guys for that?
Yeah, atypical spring night here for here in Knoxville, but it's an opportunity to get out and play in an environment that at some point next year that we're going to be in. The guys had a lot of energy tonight. They enjoyed being out there under the lights. Different type of day for a scrimmage. And for us, it's an opportunity that will parlay itself into a football game that we're going to play next fall.
How do you see the running back and linebacker positions change when you have coaching changes at those positions from last year to this year?
For those guys, the new staff members that come in here, the first thing is just gaining trust and building a relationship with your players. And that dictates how they receive all the information when you get out on the field and some of your installs too. But at the end of the day, you got that relationship. They receive the information in a different way than if they don't. And we got two guys that care about young people. They're great teachers. The transition's been really seamless with those guys. And it starts with our coordinators doing a great job of getting them on the same page with what we're doing philosophically and within our scheme. And then those guys have been really good. And that's on the grass, it's in the classroom. They're high-level coaches that there's a reason we brought them here to Tennessee.
Who are some of the guys you saw step up in the secondary? Where do you see kind of the next step for that group?
Yeah, Will Brooks had a really good night tonight. Dre's been really consistent throughout the course of spring ball. Jermaine McCoy continues to play at a really high level. Those are a few of the guys that have been consistent, but also showed up tonight for us.
Talked a lot about energy from this team, and there was a video of Dylan Sampson the other day just like hyping up the team and really just being a leader, it seems like he is. How did that show out there tonight?
Yeah, Dylan's done a great job from the time that he's got here. Transitioned seamlessly into what we do offensively. Everybody's seen the plays that he's made. He had leadership traits. He's always brought great energy out to the practice field with him or the meeting room. But he's really, thrust himself into a leadership role. And we got a great collective group of leaders that are really strong right now. And they've grown since we started, our offseason in January. There's still a lot of growth for that group. But they're intentional on impacting the people around them. When you're out at practice, seeing guys coach each other up and bring energy to each other happens on a consistent basis.
You talked about Nico. You're using this time to get your other quarterbacks ready as well. What's your comfort level with Gas right now? And without seeing the tape, how do you feel like Jay jump from scrimmage one to scrimmage two?
Merck?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Nico's got to grow here as we go through through spring. All of those guys, excuse me, you know, a bunch of guys that, you know, haven't been under the lights of game day very, very much. And Gaston's performed really consistently throughout the course of spring ball, been really good decision maker, has good control in what we're doing offensively. Jake Merkler more comfortable today than he was scrimmage one, not even close. And that's his command on the sideline in the huddle and then controlling what's going on out there. You know, there's a lot of fundamental growth left for Merk. That's typical of all the young quarterbacks that come in here, but really like that group. They encourage each other, they challenge each other, and obviously in the strength of any position, we can't just be one guy.
Touched on the last question. You guys in the secondary, how's that group overall look with so much turnover there? It seems like you're pretty athletic coming back in.
Yeah, just, you know, we knew that we had to continue to add athleticism, length, playmaking ability on the secondary. And you know, the guys that have come in here, that's high school guys and transfer portal guys. You can see that as soon as you walk on the practice field with those guys. A lot of growth left for them within our scheme, little details, nuances, and communication, but really like where that group's heading. They've made plays and you know, continue to compete at a really high level.
Thank you.
Thanks, Coach.
Hey, appreciate it.